Welcome to the aftermarket report with Vegas and Jim. Today's date is April 1st, 2019, and I'm going to hand this straight over to Miss Vegas.
Okay, well, good evening, everyone. Hope you had a nice trading day today because the markets were a lot better in terms of the SPY. I mean, it opened up at 284.70, traded as high as 286.16. And currently, after hours, still holding fairly close to this 286 here at 285.90. So nice improvement on the SPY today. And maybe we'll see, you know, a continuation throughout the week. Anything can happen, as you know. But it was nice to feel more green today than we were feeling last week. So definitely keep an eye on that. And we're all watching the SPY. Okay, so the stocks we're going to talk about today, we're going to talk about BA, we're going to talk about LYFT, LYFT, we're going to talk about AVEO, BAC, GRAM, which is GRAM, and RTIX. So let's get started. So you guys know all the drama that was happening with BA, which is Boeing, and the aircraft was grounded, all the 737 MAXs were grounded. They even had order cancellations and the stock took a significant hit. However, today, earlier in the morning, around 11:15, Rich had noticed that there was a really nice cup and handle forming on BA. And, you know, this is a very expensive stock. I mean, it was like $389. It's very pricey. And of course, you know, how many shares can you really buy when you have a smaller account? So I decided, you know what, let's just go the options route because we always like to look at that. And so we picked two different calls. We picked one call, which was a $400 strike, and that was going for 84 cents. And we also picked a $410 call, which was going for 20 cents. And, you know, because the chart at the time was so bullish, it was quite evident that there was going to be a potential breakout in the stock. And so we decided to buy these option calls on the condition that the chart was extremely bullish. And you know what? That paid off very nicely. Jim can show you. We shared the alert in the room. And there were a lot of people that actually traded and bought several of each. So some people that have a larger account bought several $84 calls, which is $84. And it went all the way as high as $2.33. So they could have sold those $84 calls for over $200 each and double the money. And then right now I saw it trading closed at 190. So they're still up over 100%. And the ones for 410 that were 20 cents each, those went as high as 65 cents. So $20 turned into, you know, $45 profit is actually not bad and quite impressive. So, it's nice to make that kind of money, especially if you go in with a bigger size. You can do quite well, even day trading this option. So doesn't mean you have to hold it until April 5th. You could have held it for the day or until it peaked at the chart and then get out and take profits. So Jim, over to you maybe on that BA chart, if you wouldn't mind just talking about what you're seeing on the chart. Because after hours, kind of a little bit around 389.90, 391.54. So what are you kind of seeing on BA right now?
I'm definitely seeing a pretty good little run on your call today. That was pretty nice. First, we're going to pull up the year's chart. You know, we had a shaky at the end of the year, and she ran all the way up, and then that bad news hit, and bam, she went back down, hit this 100 SMA about a week and a half ago. Then that news settled in, you know, and then now they're working on the situation, and it started bouncing up. So we had a high today. Let me pull up the 20-day. You can see the channel we're in right here. And then we had a bottom here last week. It might have been last Friday or Thursday, or probably that Friday when we had the big sell-off here at 360. And ever since then, she's bounced on up here to a 392. Let me look at the high here. Pull it up on a daily 1 minute. We had a 392.90. And it was almost a triple top to that level right there. And I always say, once you see a triple top and it don't hit it, go ahead and maybe take your profits, play the pullback. So we did pull back to a support level here at 388.08. I see a couple of humps right in here. This will be going to be fun to watch tomorrow. The 20-day did cross down, so did the 50, and so did the 100. It run right into the 200 SMA. So it can bounce back up to that 390.59 area, 390.60. But I would probably look for a lower support maybe tomorrow, maybe a low of 383.14. We'll just have to see how the price action goes tomorrow on this trade. So this is BA. I got three different supports, 383.14, 386.51, and 388.08. Then I have the resistance levels and the one we need to break. And let me pull up a 20-day. See if I can find me another resistance here. So yeah, the next two resistances is going to be up to the $400 mark, 476. But I expect it to pull back to the moving averages. And that's going to be BA. And the next one we're going to talk about is going to be the new IPO that just came out, LYFT.
Oh my goodness. So can I tell you, LYFT seriously needs a lift. No pun intended. I mean, the stock has hailed to lower following this IPO. Okay. And you guys know that the initial offering price was $72. So not really thrilled with the action on this. And you know what? I'm not in it, but it's not fun if other people, let's say, bought the stock at a higher price on Friday and now they're stuck in this trade. So then, you know, not a really good IPO. The shares tumbled as low as 67.78. And I, you know what, Jim, I was even looking at this after hours on LYFT, and it was back up to 69.08.
Yep.
But it did go as low as 67.78, well below the IPO price. It's still below the IPO price. Looks like investors took profits, the ones that got in a lot sooner. The stock's downtrend does suggest that, you know what, maybe some people are having buyer's remorse and they're looking to just liquidate the shares. So we'll have to see what happens. I did mention that, you know, LYFT is looking to have their own garage because for the drivers, you know, for oil changes, flat tires, things like that. They're looking to even offer them bonus pay and even offer them like free banking and also deals on car rentals if they need to use a car for, you know, to rent a car to be able to be a LYFT driver. So we'll see what happens as this IPO continues day after day. Today was day two. And not impressed with LYFT at all. And it definitely fell below the IPO price. And I guess what remains to see what happens, Jim, on your thoughts on this chart, because you were calling this as well. And, you know, we warned people on Friday, don't be touching this IPO. And you know what? I'm glad we did. And we mentioned this even last night in the video, like this is not looking good for LYFT at the moment. I mean, of course, anything can change, but right now it's not attractive. So, Jim, what do you can tell us about that chart?
I think
there's a lot of disgruntled traders here.
Yeah, I think that on LYFT itself, it does need a lift, facelift. But I expect this thing to drop to maybe $50 myself. I think it was overpriced to begin with, especially if a company's losing money, you know, hand over hand. But so they're going to probably reorganize, and then this is going to settle down. And once it settles down, people are going to start getting back in it, the big shots especially, and maybe some of us, you know, on the low part of the totem pole. But I have a target price of $50 on it. I was kind of drawing the trend lines yesterday, and then I just kind of watched it today because it kind of did what I thought it did. We did consolidate down here at right around $68.94, $69. I think it can drop another $10, $15 before people really start getting interest in it. But I'd let this stock ride out for about a week and then come in Monday with a new idea and just kind of check it out and see how she runs. But I think it's going to pull back for a couple more days and then consolidate Thursday and Friday and then probably start bouncing back up, and some of these people are going to probably cost average down and try to recoup some money out of it. And this is going to be LYFT. So I got a $50 target price, but I don't know if we'll get down that low. I just want to see my arsenal of tools start turning this thing around a little bit. And the next one we're going to talk about is one that I did a swing trade last Friday on, and that's AVEO.
Okay, so AVEO did have news after hours, and let's just see what that news was, because that was interesting news. And I'm just going to pull, and it had a nice little run. So for those of you that did swing trade the stock or traded the stock today, maybe from yesterday's report, congratulations. But what they did announce was that there was positive results from their phase 1B trial in patients with a relapsed refractory AML. So they did announce that the sponsored phase 1B for AVEO's growth factor inhibitor antibody product candidate. They said the results were presented in a poster at the American Association for Cancer Research, and the presentation was titled Sci-Fi. And looks like the results were positive, and patients with AML who are refractory to induction therapy or relapse within 1 year have had poor outcomes. And it says that it looks like the results from this did demonstrate a positive improvement, and they're looking to potentially evaluate a larger outcome study in the AML. So they look forward to this, extension of the, phase 1B, and looks good so far. So they did get good results from the trial patients. So that helps them to continue in the phase that they're doing. And I guess we'll hear more news as they, I guess, enroll probably more patients and get additional results. And Jim, over to you on AVEO.
Well, she's definitely running up after hours. I'm going to show the tape here. We're right now at 129. She did have a high of 138. I got in this stock at 70 cents and sold it earlier this morning. Wish I'd have kind of held it, but did scalp it on the way up. This is AVEO. And I'm going to post up, look at that, now we're at 130. Should probably grab me some right now, but I'm going to, while I'm doing this video, I'll just be patient and wait for it. But here's the year's chart. We did fill the gap, or we're starting to fill the gap. We did have one right down here, a high of right around my last resistance of 108. That was my target price. Now we're running up here, and we're up into the gap, which we had a high of, let me post this here. After hours, they had a high of 138, and that's right in here. So we almost touched that trend line right there to fill the gap after hours. So I expect this thing to pull back. I'm going to draw a couple trend lines on the chart. We're going to look at the 20-day. See, it had a nice little breakout here. This is what caught my attention. Then it pulled back, so I got into it early Friday morning. Got down in here right around 70 cents. Ran it up. Then we had what I would call an ascending triangle pattern, which proved to be true because we did have the huge breakout today that ran up to 138 after hours. I'm going to draw a couple support levels in here. I see one right here at 110. See another one right here right around almost 113. Another one here at 120.88. Now I'm going to pull this down to a daily 1 minute. See if I missed anything. I did. I've got a little trend line right here at 115. Then I'm on a consolidated period right here about 125, 124, with a resistance here at 138. So I'm going to pull that year's chart up again, try to find a couple other resistances. I see one right here around 150, 146.61, 149.61. Then I got another resistance right here at 160. Then I've got a final resistance right here around 172.26. That's how I look at this thing. So I'm going to pull the daily back up one more time with 3 minute. See if I missed anything. I'm going to put a trend line right about in here. Right at the 133.32, 133 level. 133.06. So, yeah, this stock's got a lot more room to play around with. The momentum's picked up. We've had a pretty nice 4 or 5 day. It's a beautiful weekly chart with a pullback consolidated period, pulling it up here on a 5-day, 5-minute. We had the breakout. She pulled back. and we created the ascending triangle right here Friday, and then today she had the huge breakout and up after hours. So I'm very bullish on this trade right now. Low support is going to be right here at 115. That's going to be a solid support. Hate for it to go any lower than that. If it does, we might see 108. So we've got 108, 115, then we've got the first two support level channels right here at 120 and also 125. Then we have the resistance channels up, and you can check them out on the early chart. You can also pause this anytime you like to draw down these support lines. This is my swing trade for Friday. It was a successful one, AVEO. And the next one we're going to talk about is a big bank, BAC, Bank of America.
Yeah, so Bank of America, you know, the interesting thing with this particular bank today is that it 200-day moving average, and we actually traded this from an options perspective. And what we actually looked to buy today was the calls, and I'll tell you which ones in particular. These were the ones for April the 5th expiry, and we picked up the ones for the April 5th, and I think it was 2850 calls, and I just have to just see and double check because my desktop just froze here. But nevertheless, we did pick up those option calls. We got those actually for a pretty good deal, and it had a nice little run today. So we did pick up those option calls on Bank of, and you know, Bank of America, I will say, is hard to trade. We did pick them up for 25 cents, so it was $25 for one contract. It could be that the earnings are coming out soon. We are seeing some bullish sweeps in Bank of America in particular, and the actual option went as high as, I saw it at one time at 40 cents, so from 25 cents to 40 cents, and as high as 44 dollars per contract. So it went from $25 contract. You could have flipped it and sold it at 40 and make $15 per contract. So that would have been nice. Even if you have a small account, you could have bought, you know, four of them for $100, and then you would have made $60 for selling all four. So you know what, not a bad return. 60% return in such a short time is actually amazing. So that's why I love to look at option opportunities, even if they're a day trade, because you can make quick money and good opportunities here. So Bank of America was one that people did trade today. And I think a few people said they kept it because they liked the way that the stock was behaving for the day. And these don't expire till Friday. So you know what? This could be something that you may want to watch if you're not in the option call. You may want to look at it tomorrow and see, you know, where does it open in the morning and decide if it's going to be something that you do trade. Also, Bank of America is looking to attract people that used to work at the company that left the workforce to look after their family. And they're looking to, I guess, woo them back in to make them come back to jobs that they were, I guess, previously held. And they want to try to attract, I guess, previous workforce employees, because as you know, it is very hard to keep employees happy, but you also have to retain employees. And sometimes people would rather spend time with their family than stay at the company. So they're trying to do a lot of, I guess, behind the scenes work to attract those people to come back. And so we'll find out down the road what are some of those things they're going to be offering to attract those people to come back. So stay tuned if I hear information on that. So Jim, what are your thoughts on the chart?
Yeah, thanks to Vegas, she's got me started to trade options, so I'm excited about learning how to do that. I just had my Tastyworks account up, so that's my option platform that I'm using, plus I can use Ameritrade. But I just got this one lit up about a month ago, and I'm learning how to trade options, and I want to thank Miss Vegas for that, because it is a small account, and I'm real good at being a chartist, and she's real good at the fundamentals. As a team, we're on top of the world. Sky is the limit.
So. Oh yeah, and you know what? I'm seeing a really nice big block of option trades on Bank of America for 89,000 shares, 89,813. and another one for 33,000. So they're, you know, they're waiting on earnings on this.
What's
so
that?
They're loading up.
What's that option scanner we have in the room?
Oh, we are using Flow Algo.
Yeah, so if you want to come
I'm
to our...
I'm beta testing another one, which I will discuss and release the name of that one once it goes to the market. But the founders of the other one have asked me to test pilot the beta version. And so I will be happy to share that one because I love the look and feel of that one too.
Yeah.
And I will definitely share it with everybody because, you know, I got to tell you guys one thing before Jim just talks about the chart. You know, I've been trading now for quite some time, almost 5 years. But, you know, I got to tell you, options is new to me. I've only been doing the options, I would say maybe the last, I don't know, four months. And, you know, maybe even a bit longer. But I got to say, I did not even know that there was such a thing as an options scanners, like option scanners that really can help you look at the flow of the money. And I mean, this is just eye opening. So, I mean, and it was because I just didn't trade options. So why would I know about these things if I don't trade options? So I've learned a lot. I'm still learning, still new, but I'm happy to share my experience with everybody because I really want everyone to learn and everyone to benefit. And especially because I'm so passionate about really helping people with small accounts, because I find it's really hard to trade stocks when you don't really have a lot of money. And I just find that when you don't have a lot of money and you trade options, especially ones like the ones from today from Bank of America, it was a nice way to make some quick money. And, you know, we're seeing some really good success. And not every option call is going to work out. But at least the nice thing is that sometimes when you're doing it with a smaller amount of money, I mean, the risk involved is really small too. So, you know, you start off small, you buy one or two contracts and you slowly grow the account. So I'm just really amazed at all these platforms out there that have option scanners. So I'll definitely be happy to do a future video that I'll do with Jim, and I'll be showcasing these scanners that I'm using, because I think it's really good that you guys, even if you work full time, you still know about these products, because down the road, if it becomes something that you like doing, this could be something that you may want to try out. So I'll be happy to talk about those, because I wish someone would have introduced them to me years ago. So you know what? I'm happy to share. And if it's going to help you, why not? Right?
Yep. And
okay.
And this is one thing that I take in consideration when I'm being in the now. Last week was a pretty rough week for a lot of these big tickers, but it didn't frighten me none at all, especially with the big sell-off we had last Friday, where, I mean, the market dipped on, not last Friday, but the Friday before that. It was a pretty bad week. And then we had a week of consolidation. But I was telling the room, I said, you know, don't freight too much, because this market's going to bounce right back. That Dow closed a couple Fridays ago, 460 points. And I wasn't worried one bit. And I said, we're going to come out here the next week. We're going to consolidate. And you can tell by Bank of America chart right here that we did consolidate with higher highs each day. I mean, higher lows and higher highs. And then come out today, this Monday, it was all took care of. We started a new week, and then we had the huge breakout on Bank of America back up here to the support levels, maybe around the first, maybe the pivot point on this 20-day chart right here. So I've been bullish on Bank of America when it was down at $5, you know, back during the deep recession. And she bounced up pretty, not as big as the other banks did, but to me, this is a pretty strong bank. And even Warren Buffett thought it was when he bought his warrants back there when it was at $5 a share. So she did pull back, had pretty good consolidation period last week, and now she's bouncing back up. So we're sitting a support level, a resistance level of 28.74 is what we hit the high today. And I'm just going to pull up the yearly chart on this thing right now just to have a little look at it. You can see it's been a pretty bumpy ride up and down. And we had that pretty rough December, and then ever since then, she bounced back up, and we've created a triple top. The last time we hit a triple top, it broke resistance, ran up to about $30. Then we had that rough week, those three, four big red candles right there. And then we had the consolidated week, and then Monday we had the big bounce up. So I think we can get back up to this range again at $30. But right now we're in a pivot point area in this channel, which support level was right around here of 2079. So I'm going to pull up 20 day. We looked at that. Now we have a little cup and handle working on right now. See the cup? And then we got the handle right here. So I'd say this is probably about the neckline here at 2829, right about in there. We're going to pull up the daily, 3 minute. See if I have a trend line that I can draw in here, and I do have one. And I'm going to draw it right here at 2849 for support. I see another one right down here, right around 2795, with another one right here at 2786. So that's not too big of a difference right there. So this stock may pull back a little bit come tomorrow with a low support of 2829, and then go ahead and proceed on up and try to hit that pivot point area of right around $30. This is going to be Bank of America. And the next one we're going to talk about is Graham, GRAM.
Yeah, so this is an interesting stock because I've traded this before, but I've never really, because it was just a quick day trade in the past, I've never really, checked out what the company does. But I got to tell you, now that this is actually a swing trade idea, for those of you that can't day trade, that do day trade, you should really be looking at this stock for a swing trade. And I'll tell you what, this company, very impressive. They are a Peruvian company with 85 years experience, and they're involved in three different business lines. They're involved in construction, real estate, infrastructure, and engineering. And they have locations in Peru, Chile, and Colombia. And they also have participated in various projects in 13 countries in Latin America and also the Caribbean. They also have over 20,000 workers. What I really like about the company, this is a family business. This is two brothers, Carlos and Alejandro. They're both brothers, and they partnered up with Carlos Montero. So Carlos and Alejandro, their names are Grana, so you get the GRA from their last name, and then Carlos is Montero. So what they did is they took the letter M, and then you have the foundation of Graham. So they're called Graham Novel Foundation. So that is kind of, how the name came about. I'm always interested in how the name came about. So that is good. So the stock is looking really bullish. I do like the fact that the company has very good history here, but the chart is what I loved a lot. And I'll tell you what I liked about it. So what I did like about the chart, and then Jim will talk about it as well, I just like the fact that the stock definitely was having a bit of a breakout today, had a nice volume surge, nice pocket pivot as well, very good support at the 200 day, and even support at the 50 day. Stock definitely is looks overbought, and I'm looking for the stock to have a continuation even tomorrow and throughout the week. So I'm going to turn it over to Jim to talk about, because I've traded the stock in the past, and I've seen this last year. It was, I think, just shy of over $4, and I'm just hoping that if this has a continuation, even though the float's pretty big, that we can actually break the 52-week high that it's had in the past and go into a new channel with Graham.
Yeah, this is an uncrowded trade as I see it, due to the volume bars down here at the bottom. So we've had a nice little 3 day, 4 day breakout here, with one of them being kind of a consolidation play right here with a small doji. And so I see a support level at 335 on this trade, up to the low support 335, 342, and 350. Then we're going to create a little resistance pivot point area right in here. So on this chart, I would say that low support area, that 335 that I mentioned, is probably the pivot point on a yearly chart right there. You can see, and it could probably go a little bit lower even, but I'm looking maybe right around that 324 with your resistance lines that we broke out of here in the past 2 days. But she has ran up pretty good from a week period for 291 all the way up to 262 to a resistance high. And we did have a yearly high of 410. And I'm going to put me a little resistance of my own right here at 402. A couple of them in there just to throw them in. Then I'm going to throw another one in right here. at 380. And I think, and I'm going to throw another one right here at 370. So I'm drawing up trend lines as we go. I'm going to pull up the 20 day now and look at it. I don't think I missed anything. Maybe I could probably raise this up, this little channel up here to from 350 to 352. That would be my little first support if she wanted to pull back. And then my low supports would be right around here, right around the 335 area, where it runs into that 20 SMA that I have right here. Also, I'm going to pull up the 1 day, 3 minute. I see a support level at 350. Definitely a support level here at 350. And I like to see it bounce up from that 350 back on up, create that double top at 370 and break out from there. But this is a very uncrowded trade. We're just going to have to see how it goes.
Well, you know what? It may have been uncrowded. I just want to comment. It may have been, it is very uncrowded if you guys look at the historical volume.
Yep.
Even like for the whole month of March. I mean, the last time we saw volume like this was back at the end of January. Mm-hmm. And here we are, April 1st, over 2.3 million shares traded today.
Yep.
And I mean, that came out of nowhere. I actually don't even see any news on the stock. And it really just looks to me, based on a technical perspective, that the stock was really just ready for the move. And I mean, people like a setup here. Especially when it crosses the 200 day, the stock was primed. So, but what volume, like it was just incredible to see this open today at 350. And, I mean, it did pull back and go as low as 330, but had a very nice close.
Yep.
So definitely looking at Graham for continuation, but what amazing volume. I will say over 2.3 million. That's incredible.
Yep. The next one we're going to talk about is going to be RTIX.
Okay, so you guys know I did say that the medical appliance equipment is going to be, I think, big for 2019. And here's another example. So RTIX, I'm not in this trade. I have never even traded the stock. And this is called RTI Surgical Holdings, Inc. They are a medical appliance equipment company. And they actually do a whole bunch of different things, but they have a tissue bank, just so you know, at the University of Florida, and they do global surgical implants with 4 manufacturing facilities. And if you visit their website, you'll see all the different things that they do. This company has been in business a very, very long time. Like we're talking back from 1969, like before I was even born, they were existing. But they have a lot of good news. Also, they had also the acquisition of Paradigm Spine, and they were a leader in the motion preservation and non-fusion spinal implant technology, and they actually completed that acquisition. So this stock here, the reason I like it as well is I liked what it had. I like the fact that it has, you know, a new 52-week high on the company, on the stock. And I'm looking for a continuation. The other thing, too, that this company does do, they do all kinds of products and implants. So if you were to, let's say, go and you have a sports injury, they do cartilage reconstruction. They do ligament reconstruction. They also do hernia repairs. I know people have had a hernia and they've had to have surgery, so they do that. They also do what they call bone matrix, which are bone grafts, so for people that need surgery in their spine. So they provide all those products and amazing technology. They also provide wound care and soft tissue augmentation. So it's a very interesting company, and obviously they're in a business that, you know what, surgeons around the world need the products. So Jim, over to you on that.
All right, this RTIX. I'm going to pull up the yearly chart first. It's what I take a good look at. Back, we had that big sell-off back in December. I keep mentioning it, but this is when I was telling people better start loading up on your favorite trades. It hit a low down here of 351, and we're looking at a 615 high today, a 52-week breakout. We had a double top yesterday, and then she went ahead and broke out here today with a doji. So this could go up higher. So let's check out one more thing here. Let's bring this. Well, let's draw a couple trend lines in here. I think I got them in. We'll have low support right around here, right around the 358 area. And I got another one right here at right around the 364. So I'm going to pull up the 20-day, take a good look at it. Looking at the 20-day channel, she kind of been up and down just a little bit, but that's healthy. Then we had last week, and then it was a consolidated week, and she kept having higher highs, higher lows. And that went for about 4 to 5 days here, 4 days in a row. And then today we kind of leveled up, had it right before the close at 605, which is my double top. We did have a 615 high pre-market, and she did pull back, hit a low support right around 593, 594. Then after hours, we're at 605 with the closing of 605. So now let's pull it up to daily 3 minute. See if I missed anything here. I got a resistance level today right around 611 with a 615 high. I'm going to draw that in, and I think we're set. We have a pullback of any kind. There'll be a low support right down here around the 583 to 584 area, but I don't know if we'll see that. And I got another trend line support right here. This is the one I'm liking a lot more, and that's at the 593 level. So I think if it pulls back any, it'll pull back to that 593, gain strength, and then bounce back up to resistance. And these are going to be your four resistance lines, and we got to break that 615. Let's pull up the yearly chart one time. I think I said we were at a yearly high. We were. So I'm just going to pull up a 3 year and see if it says anything different. We did try to break up here at the around that 388 area. Yep, 388. And then we broke past 3 or 4 days. We bounced up above it. And we created a good resistance support level here right at $6. And let's see if we can get it up to a 3 year high, which we did today. And let's see if we can break that 615. This is RTIX. Please keep it on watch. And Miss Vegas is right about the surgical equipment and stuff like that. I do think it is a bullish year for it. And then we're going to have us a little cake here at the very end.
Oh, yeah. So you know what? Happy April Fool's Day. But you know what? What I'm going to tell you guys is definitely not a joke. So Cheesecake Factory, I have to say, I seriously love that restaurant. I love the chocolate cake, the blackout cake. I just love that cake. So this company, Cheesecake Factory, they have also a location in Toronto, at the Yorkdale Mall. But they also, you know, obviously many chains in the US, but they have an amazing promotion. So they decided to offer, everybody, let me just see here. I think it was at 4 o'clock today or anytime after 4 o'clock. So I did put it also on our Facebook. Oh my God, my dog is scratching the door. Hold on. She's getting mad. Okay, so the cheesecake promotion that they have is if you could get zero delivery as well, you would get a $25 reward if you have a DoorDash account. So you can sign up, and I'm not sure if it's still available, but I think it is. It's available. This $25 reward is for the first 10,000 people. So I don't know. It's until April 7th at 11:59 p.m. And you can just visit their website, cheesecakefactory.com/promo. I'll put that in our video in case you guys want to sign up for it. So if you sign up for DoorDash and you place an order, you will then get a $25 reward added to your DoorDash account, and it can be used anytime this week for any delivery that you want from Cheesecake Factory. So they're giving this away for you, and you're welcome to check it out.
All right.
Enjoy that cake.
Now let's look at the chart a little bit here just to see what we're looking at here. And I'm going to change this to cake, and I have a cake in my freezer right now. It got me a little hungry. I'm gonna go check it out when I'm done here. So I haven't touched this in a while. We got a low support right here at 45.67. This is a pretty nice little chart, how it moves up and down all around. We've got a resistance level right here at 48.92, another support level right here, right in this spot area right here, right at 47.73 with a resistance level up here right around the $50 mark. So that's going to be my target to the 50 SMA at the $50 level. And if we can, we could bounce up to the 200 right here at 21.5140. So I'm going to pull this down to 20 day, 1 hour, see if I can add a couple more trend lines to it. I see a little resistance support level right in here, right here where we topped up. We tried to touch it up before and she pulled back pretty hard. Then I'm going to draw one right in here, right there at the 48.50, and another one right here at the 48.09 area. Another support right here. So we've had a good weekly pattern here. Actually a 2 week run from 44.39 all the way up to 49.20 with a consistent of a top. Where we did try to break it out again today but couldn't. She did pull back to support level at 48.50. So I got a low support. This is how I'm going to look at it. I got a low support right here at 47.73 with your second support at 48.09 and your first support, which she's sitting right now at 48.50 with the two resistances right here. And I'm going to add another resistance line on this thing, which I probably already have on here. Sure do. I'm going to draw one right here at the 49.32 and another one right here at the 49.53, and then we got another one right here at the 49.64. I know that's skimpy in numbers, but we're going to try to hit this top on this chart right here. And then the last one's going to be right here at 50.43. So let's bring this back up to the 20 day. We've got the different resistance lines we're going to hit. We do have a low support down here at 47.73, 48.09, and 48.50. And then we're going to try to break this top area at 49.08. And that is Cheesecake, the Cake Factory. And I think that about sums it up for the aftermarket report. And I'm going to mention something before I hand this over to Miss Vegas. This is our website. We do have a couple spots in here on the right, some icons. You can take it to personal page here at Stocktwits. You can also bring it to the Facebook page that we have. We also have some other ones. You could write to us if you ever want to. And we also have our YouTube channel right here where you can follow. Please subscribe, ring that bell, and get our future updates. And Miss Vegas, anything else?
Yeah, I'm just, you know, if anyone wants to come for a free trial, I'm happy to help you. Don't feel shy to come by. You're welcome anytime. And, you know, come check it out. And we'd love to have you. So I was happy to see quite a few people come by this weekend and getting some nice feedback from people. And I'd love to hear any YouTubers that have any feedback on our videos. You know, you're welcome to come to comment and come by the room. And if you have a full-time job and you can't always trade, we do a lot of swing trades that we share in the room. You can also follow us on Facebook. I'm going to start posting things on Facebook. So if you have Facebook, you might as well just follow us on Facebook and we can connect with you there. So, hey, why not? I like talking to people in real time. So, you know, I hope that you guys will connect with myself and Jim. We'd love to hear from you. So thank you so much.
Well, this is the aftermarket report with Vegas and Jim. Today's date is April 1st. 2019. Please subscribe and ring that bell for future updates. And we love stocks.